On January 10, 1945, American Airlines Flight 6001 departed LaGuardia Field in New York City with a flight crew of 3 and 21 passengers, bound for Burbank Airport in the San Fernando Valley of Southern California. The flight made 2 stops en route that included a crew change. The last stop was made in El Paso, Texas, where movie starlet Donna Reed was waiting to board the DC-3. Miss Reed would later go on to be a major film actress, starring in It's a Wonderful Life with Jimmy Stewart. But her flight plans the night of January 9, 1945 were changed when a military officer boarded Flight 6001 and requested her seat. During World War II, the military had priority to fly on all commercial airline flights. Here we see the American Airline commemorative postcard that actually depicts November Charlie 25684. It was called the Flagship Douglas. After Miss Reed deplaned the aircraft, the flight continued directly to Burbank, arriving over a cloud-covered San Fernando Valley at 3:55 local time. Following an unsuccessful instrument approach, Flight 6001 crashed in the cloud-enshrouded Verdugo Mountains at 4:06 a.m. The wreckage was not located until shortly after dawn, when the clouds lifted and the smoldering remains of the DC-3 could be seen from the Burbank control tower 2.5 miles away. The only parts of the DC-3 that were unburned were the outer wings and tail assembly. In the spring of 2018, members of the Project Remembrance team visited the crash site of the American Airlines DC-3 on 2 occasions. They were mindful at all times that 24 people had died at this site. 3 flight crew and 21 passengers. The 21 passengers were all military personnel from the Army, Army Air Force, and United States Navy. Today, the remains of November Charlie 25684 is a microsite, having been heavily salvaged and scavenged. And here we see a salvager's table. Routinely, aircraft wreckage was cut up and even smelted on site, the aluminum reduced to ingots. Sometimes parts were drug out and dealt with later. But the salvager's table is a hallmark, really, of that era and for many years thereafter, where wreckage was worked on at the site and then removed. Sometimes pack animals were employed. Salvagers were never able to remove all of the wreckage. They didn't get all of the aluminum, and they could not smelt anything that was stainless steel. That was always left on site. So much micro debris remains, even today, so many years later. The Douglas DC-3 was the world's first mass-produced all-metal airliner capable of cruising at 200 miles an hour and flying more than 1,200 miles nonstop. The type is well known for being used by the military as the C-47 Skytrain and C-53 Skytrooper. The standard power plant for the early DC-3s was the Wright 1820 Cyclone engine. Later, the Pratt & Whitney 1830s were used. 607 DC-3s were built between 1936 and 1942, and they could carry up to 32 passengers, plus a crew of 3. A team member finds a button from a serviceman's uniform. Items like this are always left in situ in an effort to preserve the integrity of the crash site. In respectful memory of the American Airlines flight crew, Captain Joseph R. McCauley, First Officer Robert G. Eitner, Flight Attendant Lila A. Dockin. We were only able to obtain 5 photos of the 21 service members aboard the DC-3 on that fateful day. They are Sergeant Philip Kaufman, First Lieutenant Byron W. Fisher, Private First Class Bruce H. Mankin, Corporal David O. Tanner, and Corporal Oliver R. Hoover. In respectful memory of the 21 servicemen who lost their lives on January 10th, 1945.